There are several ways in which GI bleeding presents, and in this video we'll be discussing three important signs. And the first one we'll start off with is hematemesis. So from the name, hema means blood and emesis means vomiting, so basically it means vomiting up of blood. Now, how does the blood look like? The blood is either bright red, which means there is an ongoing active bleeding and this is a medical emergency, or it can have a brownish black granular appearance, which is often described as the coffee ground appearance, which suggests that bleeding has ceased. It has this coffee ground appearance because that's how blood looks like if it has been in the stomach for a while and has been acted upon by the hydrochloric acid in the stomach. And one thing to note is that hematemesis is usually associated with upper GI bleeding. GI bleeding is classified based on a number of things, and one of them is based on the location. So we can have upper GI bleeding and then lower GI bleeding. Upper GI bleeding is bleeding that occurs proximal to the ligament of Treit, and then lower GI bleeding is bleeding that occurs distal to the ligament of Treit. The next important sign is melena. Melena is the passage of black, tarry, foul smelling stool, which is as a result of blood being acted upon by digestive enzymes. And this is also typical of upper GI bleeding, but can also occur in lower GI bleeding if the source is the small intestine or the ascending colon. And then there is hematochezia. So the prefix hema means blood, like I already said, and then chezia means to defecate. So it's the passage of fresh bright red or maroon colored blood in stool, and we can remember this with abbreviation BRBPR, which stands for bright red blood per rectum. And it's also important to note that it typically presents in lower GI bleeding. However, it can occur in upper GI bleeding if the bleeding is very brisk. So that brings us to the end of this video. It was very short. I just wanted to explain those three signs. Now the next thing is to discuss the question from our previous video. In the last video, we spoke about achalasia, and this is the question that was asked at the end of the video. A 48-year-old man complains of dysphagia, which is worse when consuming liquids. A barium enema reveals a bird's beak appearance. What is the likely diagnosis? A. Zenker's diverticulum. B. Gastroesophageal reflux disease. C. Epiphrenic diverticulum. And D. Achalasia. So the correct answer is achalasia. In the last video, we spoke about some signs of achalasia, and we learned that one of them is dysphagia, and the dysphagia has a progressive course. So it starts off with difficulty swallowing solid foods, and then it progresses to a point where they find it difficult to swallow liquid foods as well. And this man complained of dysphagia, which is worse when consuming liquids. And then we learned about the diagnosis, and we saw that an x-ray with barium contrast is one way of diagnosing achalasia. And in this case, the patient swallows barium solution, and this barium solution helps to show the outlines of the esophagus clearly on an x-ray. So after swallowing this barium solution, an x-ray is done, and a classical finding on x-ray after barium swallow is the bird's beak sign, which is tapering or narrowing of the inferior part of the esophagus that resembles the beak of a bird. And that is what was given in the question. So the correct answer is achalasia. Thank you for watching till the end. If this helped, kindly give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe, and turn on your post notification bell to be notified anytime you upload a video. And I'll see you in the next one.